All right, guys, about to jump into this week's episode, but before we do, we kind of want to go over the background of Junior. It's a deer we found this year on camera, very prominent in a few locations, and he definitely got my attention, and he became my target buck. Junior got his name from this deer right here behind me off my left shoulder. This is a deer we called Wide Load back in the 2018 season, and I ended up harvesting him with a rifle at the end of the 2018 season. Unfortunately, I didn't get him on film. I was kind of in limbo with that at the time. But fast forward, 2022, here we are. We've got a deer with the same genetics as Wide Load, and his name is Junior. So what we did is we just hunted him hard. Had a couple of encounters with him early season and had lots of intel on the Browning trail cameras. And what I want to show you today is our last encounter with Junior. All right, got Kyle back out here. We're heading to the later part of October. Bucks are kind of moving. Pulled a couple cams yesterday and put up a blind. So had some movement on those cameras, starting to pick up. Got a cold front this morning after a storm, and we're ready to get after it. Kyle's gonna be hunting 9-acre. I'm gonna be going to the east side of the pine thicket, going after Junior again. But before we get out there and get after it, we're gonna say a prayer. Lord, we thank you for this day and your creation. Lord, we pray that we just enjoy your creation while we're out there. And if opportunity presents itself, Lord, we pray that our arrow be true and meet its mark. And we pray that we bring home meat on the pole. Amen.
Amen.
Do it.
It.
Sammy knew that I was way too excited, so we're getting down before dark, and we're gonna go put our hands on Junior. No track job, we know right where he is. Go get him. Just like wide load, and that is why we call him Junior. What a beautiful deer. We'll get him out on this road. Dang, he's gray. He's an old boy. Meet on the pole, baby. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Granddad. We were actually in a stand that Granddad put up. We call it Yellow Bucket. And literally, since he bought the property probably back in the 80s, there was a Yellow Bucket under in this fence row, and that's why it got named Yellow Bucket. So we killed him out of Granddad's stand.